Remember how well SAP handles reporting on hierarchies and currencies? All of that's gone when you bring your data to Power BI. But don't worry, in this video we'll show you how to solve this. Welcome back to McCoy TV. I'm your host Wessel, and today we have an exciting topic to discuss. We'll be diving into the world of SAP formatting in Power BI, exploring some powerful features that can take your report to the next level. So let's get started. In SAP, we have a single object where we can dynamically select and navigate a hierarchy. To display hierarchies effectively in Power BI, start by selecting the hierarchy in the Query Designer and load it into the report. Make sure to select only one hierarchy per dimension. Once loaded, Power BI automatically creates a level-based hierarchy with each level represented in the columns. Now in the report, we can create a hierarchy object which allows us to easily display and navigate through the hierarchy in our report. This makes it convenient for users to explore data at different levels of granularity. By implementing restricted measures, we can ensure accurate calculations and provide users with precise insights regardless of the level of detail they choose to explore. In SAP, it's easy to create restricted measures by filtering specific levels of the hierarchy based on the single hierarchy object. To achieve this in Power BI, we can use DEX measures for each specific level we need. If you're unsure which level in a measure exists, you can utilize an OR function to search through all the levels. Next up, let's talk about keys and descriptions. Info objects in SAP allow us to show key, text, or both in the same column. Users can edit this on the go while building and exploring the report. In Power BI, we can leverage the properties of each dimension to select a non-compounded key. This selection grants us access to a key column and a description column for every dimension. In the report, we now have the flexibility to utilize this key and description column separately or combine them into a concatenated column using DAX. This empowers us to display information comprehensively. Lastly, let's explore currencies and unit of measure formatting. These can be linked to the key figure in SAP. They are then automatically displayed in the output of the key figure. By selecting the unit of measure property for the measures in the Query Designer, we can create DEX measures that are automatically formatted based on the currency selected. You can reuse this formatted measure in other calculations, and this functionality saves us time and effort, ensuring our reports adhere to the appropriate currency and unit of measure standards. And that concludes our journey through SAP formatting in Power BI. We've covered displaying hierarchies, working with restricted measures, utilizing keys and descriptions, and formatting currencies and unit of measures. I hope you found these tips helpful for your data analytic projects. If you have any questions or need assistance with your SAP or Power BI endeavors, don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below. Remember to subscribe to our channel for more informative videos like this one. And if you enjoyed this content, please give us a thumbs up.